After the first book came out, you know, a lot of the poems in that book are formal. And they are concerned with my own affairs very much. Well, of course, right away, there was came to be a kind of competition between the formalist poets and the beat poets. And they were always giving me fits because I wasn't trying to tell how to run the society. I mean, I don't know how to run my own life, much less how to run the United States. I'm pretty sure that the way we're doing it now is not it. But I turn much more to social problems and other problems in general in the second book. There's more free verse there, and no doubt maybe I was trying to compete with Allen Ginsberg and the other beat poets. I think those are the two main differences there. Also, it is during that time that I was doing this that I was with the psychoanalyst in Detroit, and he was a great help to me in doing the poems about paintings that are in there. In the meantime, I think I was kind of casting about for a subject matter, and so it seems to me the second book is less unified. Also, that second book contains a number of translations at the end, and there isn't anything like that in the first book. The first book is all my own poems. Mm-hmm. And I think perhaps I was looking for another subject like that. And there was loss of my daughter, I thought, and the loss of my sister, and I thought, you know, well, for instance, then when the second marriage broke up, I lost my son and my stepdaughter. But I thought, I can't write about that anymore. I've already done that. And I'm looking for something new and different to do. And I think the second book involves more sort of hunting for subjects. And the poems about paintings came up at that time. Partly because I was asked by the University of Rochester to teach an evening course out at a little mansion that they had in a small town nearby, and this was to be a course in modern art, and I told them I don't know anything about modern art. They said it doesn't matter. This is adult education. You don't have to know anything. Well, very luckily, I had very bright students who said such clever things that it got me started doing the poems about paintings. So I did five of those, I think. I was still, you know, casting about for doing all these translations was one of the ways I was looking for subject matter.